Good evening, students. Welcome to yet another session of statistics. And today we will be discussing mean, median, mode with certain examples and the concept of skewness. As we have seen in the last lecture, that there are two types of statistics. One is descriptive statistics and the other one is inferential statistics. So, in the descriptive statistics, we are trying to measure data in terms of quality or quantity. We try to find out a summary or overview or the description of data. Now you will say, what is description of data? For example, I have marks of 10 students and I want to find out the quality of data. That is, what kind of marks the students scored. Are they good? Are the marks bad or very bad or excellent? So quickly, what I can do? I will take an average and I'll try to find out the average marks, so that I can understand the quality of marks. Now suppose the marks of the students are in such a manner that the average is 85. So I can say that yes, the class average is good. It is more than distinction. If it is, let's say, 45%, I will say the class average is not good. But if I'm just finding out the average, I'm not able to understand the distribution of marks. It can happen that one person has got 100 and the other person has got 0. And there were some students who scored in between 0 to 100 and they have also maintained, and that is why the average is 85. So those are the questions which we can very easily understand with the help of statistical tools called as mean, median and mode. Now in descriptive statistics, we deal with numbers, we deal with frequency counts, percentage, deciles, quartiles, measure of central tendency, mean, midpoint and mode. Midpoint is also called as median. Variability, variance and standard deviation, graphs and normal curves. So these are the main tools of statistics which are used to understand the data, to describe the data, what is the quality of the data. Let's understand the means of central tendency. There are three types of averages. One is the mode, second one is the median, and the third one is the mean. So we will see all three of them with few examples and understand what does it mean when I'm saying that it is the measure of central tendency. As you can see in this example, there are 11 test scores ranging from 61 to 92. And you can see that 81 is the middle value. So basically, median is a value which exactly divides a list of numbers into two halves. If a number is exactly dividing a list of numbers into two halves, I can say that is the median value. You can see over here, the median is 81. Half of the scores fall above 81 and half of the scores fall below 81. So we can say that midpoint is the distribution below which half of the cases reside. Let's take one more example. First, introspect the data, the six scores. They are 3, 3, 7, 10, 12 and 15. Now in this case, you can see there are two middle values. One is 7 and the other one is 10, which means there are even set of numbers. In such cases, we can very easily take the two middle values and take out their average, and we can say that value becomes your median value. So here you can see 7 and 10 are the middle values, which is the third and the fourth value. We take the sum of the third and the fourth value and divide by 2. That is, we are finding out the average and we are saying the middle value is 8.5. So this is yet another way of finding out median when there are even numbers in the list. Take one more example, insensitive to extremes. Now in this case, you can say median value is not sensitive to extreme. The extreme value is not affecting the median value. In other words, in this example, the extreme value is 200, but the median value is 10. So we can say when we have a list of numbers and we have arranged them in ascending order, whatever value comes as the median value is considered as the median. and we say the values below the median value are lower than median value and the values above the median value are more than median value. But it will never tell you the extreme cases. Those extreme cases can be very easily found with the help of mean. Let's come to mean now. We also call it arithmetic average. Mean is average of set of values. We all are since childhood dealing with average, percentage, mean value, average score, average percentage, average score in terms of cricket, everything. So everywhere we have used this word average, averaging. Here in this example, you can see the scores are 5, 6, 7, 10, 12 and 15. And their sum is 55 and the number of scores are 6. Number of scores 6 means n values are there and here n is 6. So computation of mean gives 9.17. So the average of this set of value is 9.17. So in this case you can say mean is influenced by the extreme cases. In case the extreme value is too high or too less, you will find that the mean will increase or decrease accordingly. Like in this case you can see the list of value is having 2, 23, 34, 90, 90, 90 and 100, which means the values are quite high. Four values are quite high. So you will find that the mean would be quite high. But it is because it is influenced by 100, which is quite a high value. Extreme cases are quite high. So we call such values sometimes as outliers, and sometimes these extreme cases don't let us understand the spread of data. What kind of data it is or which data is existing most in a particular set of data. This kind of calculation is appropriate with interval and ratio data, where we have data in terms of interval. When we collect data in terms of interval, in that case it is easy for us to calculate mean. Now there is a question for you all just to revise. There are four options: strongly agree, agree, disagree and strongly disagree. Is this 4-point scale ordinal or interval? Now this is a question I am throwing on you. You have to decide whether it is ordinal or interval. So students, this is ordinal data. Ordinal data where we are giving numbers to particular option and we are arranging data in terms of rank. That is ordinal data. It is not interval data. Interval data is that data where we give ranges like age group between 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40. So this data in front of you is ordinal data. Now let's come to the next topic, which is called as mode. Mode is basically used to find out the frequency. The frequency of a value occurring in a set of values. The most frequently occurring value in a set of values is called as the modal value. Now, for example, I have taken a survey and the respondents are either male or female. So in that case, I have to find out that who have given more responses, whether they are male or they are female. So in that case, you can see in the example over here that there are 5 values, 3 males and 2 females. So the most occurring value or the modal value is male over here. So like this, when in a list of values, we try to find out the most occurring value, that value is called as the modal value. So quickly we have discussed mean, median, mode, and now we will also see what is a distribution. Now this picture in front of you is called as normal curve. This is also called as a bell curve. You all can see that at the center or at the midpoint you can see mean, median and mode. When we do repeated sampling of a population, and that result in a normal distribution. That is, the clustering of values is around a central tendency. Then in that case, it is coming as a normal curve or a normal distribution. So mainly whenever we are doing repeated sampling, we try to create a normal curve. And in the case of normal curve, the mean, median and mode, all three fall at the same point, which means that the mean, median, mode are almost at the same point, that the sample that we have collected from the population is showing very little or negligible deviation. So this is a normal curve. You all can see it is bell-shaped, and here the mean, median and mode, all three are coinciding at the same value, that whatever is the mean is the median and is the modal value, which means that the data is almost alike. The data has very less exceptional cases or outliers. Now we will discuss something called as skewness. Now skewness is a concept which can tell us very easily that whether the result is deviated or not. There can be two types of skewness: skewness to the right, and we call it positive skewness; skewness to the left, and we call it negative skewness. For example, let's take that we conducted a test on students and that question paper was very hard, and that results in a lot of low marks or low grades. So you can see that the particular graph will be skewed to the right. It is skewed to the right, which means that more students have scored low grades or less marks in the test. So the graph is skewed to the right. We call it positive skewness. Now, this is positive skewness because the graph is skewed to the right. Now, in this case, you can see that the mode or the modal value is less than the median, and the median is less than the mean. So for the set of values, we will find that mode is quite less and the value of median is even lesser than the mean. Let's take another example of negative skewness, and it will be again clear to you all. It's an extremely easy test if given to you all, or maybe to the students. It will result in a lot of high grades. So as you can see in the graph, that the marks are of high grades can show you the bell on the left hand side. And here you can see that the mean is lesser than the median and the median is lesser than the mode. You can see over here the order of the measure of central tendency, which is opposite to the positively skewed distribution. Now in this example, you can see very easily that mean is less, then median is greater, the middle value is greater, and then the modal value is highest, which means the most occurring element is highest. So we can say that when the exam is easy, more students are scoring more marks in terms of 90% or 80%. So the modal value is quite high. So that is how we try to understand the skewness, whether it is negative skewness or positive skewness. Next concept that we will be discussing in the coming lecture is variability, and I'm stopping here. Just a quick revision, or you can say a quick tour on the distribution. What is a distribution? We have discussed mean, median, mode, and we have seen that there is a normal curve when mean, median, mode all coincide, but in case the mean, median, mode are not coinciding, in that case the curve starts shifting. It can be a case where the skewness is right, and we call it a positive skewness. In such case, the mode is less than mean and mean is lesser than the mode is less than median and median is even lesser than mean. And then we have negative skewness, when we see that the mean is less than median and median is less than mode. So we are trying to understand with the help of this graph the distribution of data, that how the data is distributed, and then we try to understand the dispersion or the data, how much it is around the mean. So this was an introductory lecture on mean, median, mode and skewness. In the coming lecture, we will be discussing all the four concepts very in depth and with some more examples. Now what you all have to do is, I will be giving you an Excel video recording of my two lectures, wherein in one video lecture I have demonstrated how to use these statistical tools in Excel and calculate the data, and in another lecture I have discussed how to use functions in Excel to understand the data and categorize the data on the basis of some characteristics. So I stop here. This is Dr. Shubhi. After listening to this lecture, quickly open up your laptops and start doing the Excel demos, and be prepared for your test which is coming for the next week. Thank you so much. Good night.